Now, in this video, we're going to be talking on the Fieder-Kraft alkylation and acylation reaction. Now, this reaction was discovered by two chemists, Fieder and Kraft, so they actually named it after themselves. So that's the reason for the name Fieder-Kraft acylation and alkylation. Now this is the generation of an alkyl benzene. Now, I'm talking about the Fieder-Kraft alkylation, so let's just start with it at first. Then we'll go to the Fieder-Kraft acylation. Now, this is generation of an alkyl benzene from the reaction of alkyl halides and benzene. Now, the reagents involved in this include an alkyl halide and a Lewy acid, in this case, aluminium chloride. That's the Lewy acid, in this case, aluminium chloride, and that's just all we need to know. Now, I gave you the equation of the reaction at first. Now, this leads to the formation of the carbocation ion and also the formation of the aluminium chloride ion, and therefore, we can actually see the positive charge and every single thing that we need to know. Now, I'm actually going to be talking about how this reaction occurs, like the mechanism of this reaction. It's not a hard mechanism, it's just an easy mechanism, just like we see from the alkyl benzene, and therefore all of this we can actually decode it from there. Now, I've already formed my electrophile, and that's like the carbocation ion, so we can actually just combine it with our benzene immediately. I will end up leading to the formation of with the R dot, and therefore this will actually be formed. This is the benzonium ion, and this is my R group actually combining, and this is my H group actually combining. Now, this step is the slow step. Now, then, second step is actually the loss of this hydrogen, to the nucleophile, and that's like the next step. Then we have this second step, is the benzonium ion, then the loss of the R group, then we have something like this. This R group is end up being lost to the nucleophile, being aluminium chloride. So AlCl4, we have this, so it's therefore lost, and it leads to the formation of aluminium chloride, AlCl3 and HCl, and that's just all we need to know about that. It's not really a hard reaction. So let me just erase this and just give you the list of the products that are actually going to be formed. Now, the first product, like I said, is an alkyl benzene, and that's this, the R group. It could be methyl benzene, that's toluene, and so on. The next product that's actually going to be formed is aluminium chloride, and the aluminium chloride, like the catalyst, you can say, remains unchanged. And then hydrogen chloride gas or hydrochloric acid, if it's in solution. So we can actually go on with this one and actually continue talking about this reaction. Now, there's something I want to talk about right now, and that's the limitations to the Fieder-Kraft alkylation reaction. This is where the Fieder-Kraft reaction, like the alkylation reaction, this is where it doesn't go. We all need to understand this. Now, for allyl, the first one I'm actually going to talking about, first limitation, allyl and vinylic halide cannot be used because they do not readily form carbocations readily. Now, this is like easily self-explanatory. We all know that an alkyl group could be anyone. It could be formed from an alkane, alkane, or alkyne. Now, the allyl group, we all know the allyl group to be this CH2 double bonded with CH, then single bonded with CH2. These are allyl group, and the vinyl group still like this. CH2 double bonded with CH, yeah, double bonded with CH. Now we have something like this. Then this is our vinyl group, this is our allyl group, so I can actually just call this vinyl. Now, this is all we know, but this, like, when they combine with chloride, so let me just actually give you the allyl chloride and the vinyl chloride. Now, like I said, allyl chloride and vinyl chloride, they don't readily form carbocations readily. Now let's just say this allyl halide, let's use allyl chloride and vinyl chloride. Now we can see they don't readily form like the carbocation easily. That means this is mostly because we can actually see the resonating effect is actually making all of this stable. This double bond can actually move, this can actually move and actually be coming back, giving this positive and whatever. And we all know something about resonance, that resonance actually like inhibits like the like actually increase the stability of a compound and so on. Now that's also like the reason for this reaction, and that's the reason why they don't actually form carbocation straightly, and that's if the first limitation to alkylation, and that's first limitation to Friedel-Crafts alkylation, because when they don't form the carbocation, we can't actually combine them with the benzene group and actually lead to the formation of something. So that's like the first limitation. Now the next, in the presence of powerful electron withdrawing groups such as NO2 nitro group and NH2, that's the amine group, now they give poor yield or tend to combine less readily due to the electron withdrawing effect. Now we can all see from this, look at nitro group. Nitro group is so powerful, like it's an electron withdrawing group. We all know this. Also, the amine group is also an electron withdrawing group, and because of this, they tend to like from this, we can all see that they tend to give like a weak, or what should I say, they tend to withdraw like the electrons. And when benzene group, if I may put it in this way, it's undergoing resonance, it has double bond, the double bond are resonating. Now imagine the double bond being like, what should I say, being dragged on by this group. Then when the double bond is being withdrawn by this group, we end up seeing that instead of benzene to even regardless of stability is a major factor. We need a strong reagent in order to do this. Now because of another factor again that actually trying to inhibit the double bond and whatever, we end up seeing that they tend to give poor yield. Like now nitrobenzene will combine easily again. It can't combine. We all know that it is metal direction. Regardless of that, metal directing is always a slow combining whatever, and because of this poor yield that they end up giving metal directing groups instead of auto and para directing groups because of this poor combining effect. And that's just all about the second point. Now the third, they tend to undergo skeletal rearrangement because primary alkyl halides are used. Now your primary alkyl halides are used in the nitro, like in the Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Now there's something we all need to note. Because of primary alkyl halides are used, when the group when the like when they end up forming the like carbocation and the chlorine or the halide group or the halide ion, we end up seeing the skeletal rearrangement in the alkyl group, and we end up forming something like really complex. If I may put it, let's just say something like this. Let's just say something like this. This is what we actually use to combine. I'm not going to be including the hydrogen. This is our carbocation. Now, at the end of the day, we end up seeing something like this. See, let me just divide this. See, let me just include the carbon. See, I will end up forming something like this. See. And at the end of the day, we actually see that most of the times, primary alkyl halides end up giving tertiary groups. At the end of the day, that's not the result we wanted, and at the end of the day, that would be frustrating enough, but that would not like actually give us the compound we're actually looking for. Now the last effect is due to electron donation effect, the alkyl group tend to be more reactive compared to benzene group, compared to benzene, and this could lead to polyalkylation of alkyl benzene. Now the alkyl benzene, imagine after we're done with this reaction, we end up getting our product, that's the alkyl benzene. Now, because of the presence of an alkyl group, we all know is an electron donating group, it loves donating electron. Because of the presence of that alkyl group in the benzene atom, we end up seeing that that alkyl benzene ends up becoming more reactive than the benzene. Benzene is already stable now, an electron donating group is already present, and that tends to keep attracting electron seeking group, if I may put it that way, that's the nucleophile and so on, and that will lead to the formation of, or what should I say, polyalkylation of alkyl benzene, and that's what is always happening, polyalkylation, and that will end up giving us a different result than what we wanted. Imagine we want methyl benzene and we end up forming something like propyl benzene, and that is really bad. That's not actually what you wanted. So that is like the four factors that affect Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Now these factors are also important, so we need to note them. Now Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Now, like the alkylation reaction, instead of now let's just go on. This involves the introduction of an acyl group. The acyl group is the CHO group. CHO group, there's a negative charge, if I may put here. Negative charge leads, it could be either acyl chloride and so on. Now the acyl group to a benzene molecule. The reaction is similar to the alkylation reaction. It involves aluminium chloride. That means aluminium chloride that we saw as a reagent in the alkylation reaction is also involved here, and acyl chloride as the reagent. Now, it involves aluminium chloride and acyl chloride. Those are the reagents. And at the end of the day, we end up seeing that it's the acyl group that ends up becoming our electrophile and so on. Now, this leads to the formation of acylium ion. The acylium ion ends up becoming our electrophile, and this ends up becoming our nucleophile. So that's all we just need to note about this. Now, I'm actually going to be just talking about this, I think, the reaction mechanism and so on. Now, from this, we can actually see what happens, like, between the electrophile and the nucleophile, the reaction to form the like electrophile and the nucleophile. Now, I'm just actually going to be giving us the combination reaction. Now, the benzene group. This is our benzene group. Now, this benzene group ends up combining with the acylium ion, that is triple bonded with O, positive charge. We can all see. Now, then, this ends up leading to the formation of an acyl benzene, if I may call this. This is it. So we can actually say this is RCO, and this is the hydrogen. Now, these are the two things that are actually going to be formed. Now, like the previous one, then is the loss of the hydrogen by the nucleophile. And so that's now the next step of the reaction. That's the loss of the hydrogen. Let's just call this out. Or let me just erase this line. So now the loss of the hydrogen. So we have this. Let's say this is the hydrogen. And this is the acyl group RCO. Now, in the presence of the AlCl4 ion, then the hydrogen is actually lost to this, and this will end up leading to the formation of an acyl benzene, if I may call this the RCO, and HCl and AlCl3, that's the aluminium chloride. Now, this is just like the reaction mechanism for the reaction. It's not actually a tough reaction mechanism. We can all see that the reaction mechanisms of benzene, except for the addition reaction, benzene also undergoes addition reaction, but it takes place under different conditions. Now, for the substitution reaction, like all the reaction mechanisms for the substitution reaction are alike. They are just substituting, just like that reaction mechanism for alkyl groups and so on. They are also alike in this one. So that's just all we need to note about that. So that is all about the Friedel-Crafts alkylation and the acylation reaction. So thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.